held here for 6 years, her murder unsolved. But tonight, once again, Fayetteville police confirm what the mother told us earlier. The suspect, 26-year-old Rico Cohn, has been arrested and charged with capital murder in the death of Ingram. Judy Ingram, at least, has one burning question answered now. A face and a name, finally, a suspect has surfaced. We'll continue to follow late-breaking developments on the Nina Ingram story for you right here on 4029 TV and online at 4029TV.com.
Your child's vaccines may not be working, according to a new government report. The problem the report found was some vaccines were not stored properly, making them ineffective. Locally, our medical community says they need a close watch on how our vaccines are stored. Now, with the medical scare, we went to a local pediatrician to see what it all means.
And it doesn't create any safety issues. It's not like you're giving the child something that could harm them. It's just that the vaccine efficiency and protective nature of the vaccine may be diminished if it's given later than it was intended, or if it was allowed to, you know, thaw out or get to room temperature.
If you have any concerns about your kids' vaccinations, just call your family doctor.
We have sad news to report tonight. Another person has died in Arkansas waters. It's the fourth death in recent memory in our community, and all are related by one fact. None were wearing a life jacket. The latest drowning happened at Sugarloaf Lake. Investigators say the family was swimming, and the victim may have been drinking.
From what I've been told, that there were no life vests that were being utilized at all, and that's a tragedy. You know, we have a great upcoming summer, so I encourage everyone who is going to get out on our lakes to please be safe, have fun, but most of all, wear a life jacket. It's extremely important.
The Sebastian County Sheriff says no one noticed at first that Reed was struggling. His mother eventually saw him and tried to swim out and help, but he went under by then. His body has been sent off to the state medical examiner for an autopsy.
Truly a sad story, but with the water getting warmer, more and more people.